Good day to Dr. Razif. We are from Group 1 and our topic is cell disruption method. And this is our group members. First of all, I will present on the introduction. Cell disruptions is required when the product protein is not expressed extracellularly and the host cell has a tough cell wall, example E. coli. It can be classified into two, which are non-mechanical techniques and mechanical techniques, where we will only focus on mechanical techniques in our presentation. The principles of the mechanical techniques are the cells are being subjected to high stress field pressure abrasions with rapid agitations with beats or ultrasound. Intensive cooling of the suspension is required after the treatment to remove heat generated by the dissipation of mechanical energy. Next, I will pass the presentation to Juxian.
Thank you, Helene. The first method is beat meal. It is a solid shell method which cells are being subjected to abrasion with rapid agitation with beats. It consists of a jacketed grinding chamber with a rotating shaft which is running in center. Agitators are fitted with the shaft and it provides kinetic energy to the small bead and make the bead collide with each other. Velocity glass bead is typically used and the choice of bead size is greatly dependent on the type of the cell. The increased number of bead increases the degree of disruption due to the increased bead-to-bead interaction. Next, the application is used to extract wallacin from yeast and it is used in pharmaceutical field, which is grinding of pharmaceutical nanoparticles. Next, the advantages are it is a rapid process, it is effective against cell wall with rigidity, and the apparatus can be actively cooled to prevent heat-dependent damage to the pigment. The disadvantages are high chance of contamination, result can be unpredictable and fine-tuning is required, and it can consume considerable amount of energy if parameters are not optimized. I will pass the presentation to Lia.
I would like to talk about the rotor stator meter. The rotor stator meter is also so-called as a collect meal. It's used to reduce the particle size of solid in suspension in a liquid, and it's used to reduce the droplet size in emulsion. It aids in increasing stability of the suspension of emulsion too. Next, how it works is that it's based on rotor stator principle. A high-speed rotor pushes a cell fluid through small holes in the stationary stator, creating extremely high levels of mechanical shear. The cells are tear apart due to the mechanical shear. The higher the mechanical shear, the smaller the resulting the cell size. Next, application we have three here, which include the preparation of suspension, paper production, and soap production. Next, main advantages is that this device is simply constructed and is very, very easy to be operated. As for the disadvantages is that it has no wide application in terms of solid, and this is not based on fine grinding. Next, I'll pass the presentation to Muhammad Faris.
So I'm going to present about French press. So French press piston. The piston forces the liquid sample through a needle valve under high pressure. As the sample passes through the valve, the cell experiences shear stress. So when the cell passes through the valve, they will decompress and cell expand and rupture. So next. So for the application of French press, it can actually be used to brew coffee and tea. It can also be used in terms of biochemistry engineering application. It can use for dissemination of chloroplasts, homogeneous animal tissue, and other biological particles. So last but not least, I'm going to talk about the advantages and disadvantages of French press. So advantage would be adjustable and modulated. Non-repeated shear force, we will limit the damage to the liquid bed structure and also reduce contamination of the sample due to the stainless steel equipment. So this measure will be a small sample size and that will be rather expensive due to the low throughput. So another thing, it will require pre-processing and sometimes it will tend to clog the needle valve. As well, it's not user-friendly. So I think that's all from me. We're going to pass it to Matej.
About ultrasonic vibration. So basically, ultrasonic vibration utilizes the mechanical forces to shear tissues and cells where this force takes the form of ultrasonic sound waves. This can be done either using an ultrasonic bait or prop. So when it comes to question how it works, both bait and prop sonic cables utilizes high energy sound waves in the range of 20 to 100 kHz to disrupt the sample. Prop sonication used to the disruption of cells, and both bait sonification are useful for the large batch preparation of tissues and cells. Ultrasonic treatment can be disintegrated in fibrous cellulic materials into fine particles and break the cell walls of the structures. So next, for the application, in modern laboratories, ultrasonic homogenizers are used to break the cell walls. Disruption of tissue cultures also can be done where the subcellular components and virus are disrupted without any destruction. Ultrasonic vibration used in genetic research, for example, like extraction of DNA and human material. Other than that, it will be used for the urology biochemical membrane analysis on the component of the spermatozoa as well. Next, for the advantages, it's available, non-invasive, and we're using the sound waves. Next, advantages will be the small sample quantities are to be processed very quickly and cost-effectively. And for the disadvantages, more resilient tissues such as muscle requires an upstream primary disruption, such as blending. When it works with the microliter quantities, forming and splashing out of the vessels are a bigger problem. And lastly, in order to dissolve large quantities of continuously, special flow vessels made of glass or stainless steel with the sonication chamber are used. Next, I'll pass it to Kavinis now.
Conclusion, there are several considerations should be studied before choosing the appropriate method for cell disruption, such as the optimum parameters and energy consumption. The four methods proposed have its own drawbacks, as you can see here. Therefore, we have suggested that the French press is the most effective method because it is scalable, high efficiency, and also easily adapt to different size of samples. At bottom on your left, you have attached our QR code for our references for this presentation. That's all from us. Thank you very much.